Yeah.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, now we're acting like we don't follow him on Twitter, eh? Okay. Yeah. Yeah, if we act like we don't know what's happening, then... I know. Oh. Damn.
Guy's so sweet. No, you don't. You're not on Twitter. Should I be following?
Go for it. Go for it.
What are you talking about? Never mind.
Never mind. It's fine.
Clouds.
Clouds.
We need a good tune right now, guys.
Yeah, so we're seeing Matt Rife very soon too, guys. But a bunch of you said that I can't film Matt Rife, right? Like, I can't film that comedy show. Like, I can't go live, right? He's gonna yell at me. But I kind of want him to yell at me, you know? It's a week Monday, 20th of March, yeah. We're seeing him in London, Ontario. I'm literally driving 2.5 hours to go to this comedy show, watch Matt Rife, and driving all the way home. So 5 hours of driving, like... Yeah, it's not allowed. What if we're sneaky? You can't video him. Okay, I'll let you know how it is. He won't yell at you. Ask Anne-Marie, she'll know. Anne-Marie has like 4 videos of his that have like she's gone viral with his vids. She has one video that has like 3 million views. Why London? He's coming to Toronto. I couldn't get the tickets in Toronto. Honestly, I booked it when I was in London because I had so much fun in London, but I don't think I'm going to do what I did last time. I'm not going to stay in London. Yeah, we have blinkers where we live. Yeah, they sold out quick. There was one seat left. Yeah, literally, I think there was two. There's two left when I booked it, and I booked it when we went to London, so a while ago. In Niagara, they escorted you out if you caught you filming. Okay, yeah, definitely I'll pull out my phone now. Why not see the night, though? No. It was a cool experience to go back, but I'm 30. You know what I mean? So it's like, it was cool, it was fun, but I don't know. You drive back too. Yeah, I'll just go there for the night, or just go there for that evening and come back. From here to London, yeah, it's about 2.5 hours. 2 hours, if you drive fast. Rather sleep in my own bed. Yeah, honestly, guys, the Airbnb I stayed in last time, which was like one of the only ones available, I got like really bad bed bug bites. So I'm like, yeah, just come home. Tracy, hello. When I go to something in Detroit, I don't stay, I drive back. Detroit, yeah. You guys know Windsor, Ontario? So like Windsor is right before the border of US. It's like Windsor, Ontario, and then it's like Detroit. Apparently you can buy a house in Windsor for like 150K. It's crazy. But like, who would live in Windsor? You know? You're 2 hours in Detroit right now. Lynn, thank you for the follow. Yeah. Oh, you guys like the other song? Kind of like Nelly Furtado, though. All right, fine.
Done. Love is pain, but I need it. It's too good when the beam kicks in. Like Fortnite, I'ma need your skin.
I like the drive to London. It's nice. Just down Highway 401. Just keep going west. It's peaceful. I did it so many times. Sean Desmond and Nelly are collabing. That's a cool collab. Where would you buy a house if you were going to buy one? So I'm looking into it a little bit. Just thinking about it. But yeah, I don't know, to be honest, where I'm going to live. I'm not too sure where I want to like start, you know, the next chapter of my life. Sounds like really like cliche, but I don't know where I want to start it. Why do you hate to drive? I don't know. I don't like driving that much. It's like boring. Good morning. Good morning. Those waking up. Take care of yourself, Reid. Thank you. You too. Two small houses. One there. One in Florida. The question is like where here though, because yeah, I could live in the States if I want to, right? We could literally like pack up everything and go right now to the States, but I think it comes with pros and cons too. So I don't know. I gotta really think about this. This is a big move. Next move is a big move. So we gotta think about this properly. Bye, Amanda. Yeah, I want to be close to family. It's important. Then again, Blackie 18 Dad's not really close anymore because he's basically like in Niagara / Florida. Like those are his two places now. I think he's selling his Richmond Hill place. So, Abel, thank you for the follow. Hi, Lisa. Mm-hmm. House and car shopping are the worst. You wouldn't stay in Richmond Hill. I don't know. It's kind of like, I've lived here for 31 years, right? So I don't know if I want to like continue. Like, I don't, it's just a long time to be in the same city. So Florida. Yeah, so basically we're going to Florida. I don't know. Like, I don't know if I'm going to rent for a year or like, I want to try to like live on my own. I'm kind of scared. I'm not going to lie. It's a big change for me, but I was actually supposed to move out at 24. I had an offer on a place, but like it didn't work out, and then I just kind of got really comfy. But change is good, right? But I'm really scared to take that big step. It's a big step for me. So, but it's gonna happen eventually, right? Like, so. You lived all 60 years in Ontario. Wow. Ontario is good. There's nothing wrong with Ontario. Hi, Deanna. You just gotta do it. I look up to people who have their own place, honestly. Like, if you have your own place, like, whether you're renting or buying, if you have your own place, it's a lot of responsibility, and I look up to you. You just learn, right? You just learn. It is stressful. Do you guys remember when you first got into your first place? Whether you're renting or buying, like, when you got your own place. Were you really stressed the first month? Like, just, or was it exciting? Like, I can imagine being so stressful because you have so many things that you normally didn't have to do for yourself. It's exciting. Okay. If it happens and you guys are still in the picture, you're going to help me cope. Because I think I'm going to be really like, yeah. Oh, you moved in with a hubby. See, if I moved in with someone, it's different. But I'm not moving in with anyone. I don't want a roommate. And I don't have a girlfriend, so. Can we help decorate? Of course. Why would we not be in the picture? I don't know. I hope you are. They'll be stressed too. Yeah. See, like, obviously the part of owning is nice, but then, like, if something breaks, like, it's all you. That part scares me. If I'm still around, am I going somewhere? I sure hope not. Living alone, there's no surprise when you come home. I know, I really got to get used to the fact that, like, things aren't going to be the way I always like it, you know? Like, so, like, when I have, like, a family one day, I have to get used to mess. Like, I have to. I have to get used to the fact that, like, where I leave my toothbrush might not be in the exact same place when I come back to it next time. Because right now, like, the way it is, everything has to be a certain way for me. So, like, when my nephew comes downstairs and starts moving things around, I'm like, whoa, you know? But, like, I have to get used to that. I'm very rigid, yes. I'm very rigid. OCD, yeah. So, I gotta get used to mess. I gotta get used to the fact that life's not perfect and things are not always gonna be the way that I like. But I'm learning. Like, I remember when I was teaching, okay? Every time I had a supply teacher come in, I'd leave them notes, like, what to do. But I come back in the next day, okay? And, like, my stapler is on the other side of the classroom. My pencil, I can't even find it. My scissors are, like, underneath a desk. I'm like, yo, I can't do that. Like, that stresses me out so much. A lot. Yeah. But you get used to it. You get used to it. Supply teacher. I never supplied, but when I had a supply. Your ruler, we know where that is. True. A girl will change everything on you. Toiletries, blankets, pillows. Oh boy. Clothes, shoes. I know. I'm the same way. Like, when you use something, why can't you put it back? Holy. If I use something as someone's, I put it back exactly where I found it. But I get that not everyone's brain works my way the same way. Hi, Erica. You won't have time to tidy when the kids come home. So, come along. So, wait, like, do you just not clean? What's a supply teacher? Oh, a substitute. I think that's the word that you might use. Substitute? You pick your battles. Substitute, like a teacher that replaces you when you can't come in. Yeah. And I remember it was the biggest testament when I get like a note the next day and it was like, your students are so well behaved. You did such a good job. I'm like, I feel like they're my own, you know? I'm like, I know. And then I'd get one like another year and it was like, I will never come back to this classroom. I don't know how you do it. I'm like, I know. I'm not a substitute, no. I was a permanent teacher, yeah. You clean one room, turn around, and another's a mess. Okay, at that point, I give up. If I clean a room and I turn around and another room's messy, I'm like, I'm done. Okay? Yeah, I'm very, very organized. Like, too organized. But you get used to it, right? It's all part of life. That's when you get a cleaner. True. It's all part of having kids. Don't teach toddlers. I actually was going to teach kindergarten one year. Very close. It was between kindergarten and grade 6. And I had the choice. And I was like... But then I remember that I have to like finger paint and stuff with them, and like I get really messy, and I was like, oh, like if there was paint all over the place, I would flip. Plus, I really enjoyed having like with my grade 6 students, I always had like really good conversations about life, you know, and you can't really have that with a kindergarten student. I don't like living alone. I have never lived alone. Never lived alone. Yeah, because when I was in university, I had a roommate. And I lived in a house with a bunch of guys. Never lived alone. I really want to try that, though. Never. Mm-mm. Yeah. I don't want to freaked out. I am really scared about it. I know I can do it, but I'm nervous. It's a big step. Tammy, hello. Connie, thanks for tapping. Guys, we tapped 117,000 times. Thank you for tapping. Never lived alone as well. Your favorite grades are 5 and 6. Same. You have us, remember? It's true. It's true. Talk to Joshua. Yeah, I look up to him. He's got his own place. He's way younger than me. He's figured it out. Josh has figured it out quick. Josh is going to be married in like the next 2 years. Watch. I was done with roommates, so I moved out and lived alone. Yeah, no, I don't want roommates. I want my next roommate to be my wife or girlfriend, you know? I don't want to just live with someone. Go to Florida and buy a house with them. No roommates. You never know what goes on behind the scenes. True. Josh will love to hear that. He's doing well. He's doing well. But the way I used to look at it was like kind of like a race. Like if you're married before me, if you have your first, like it, all these things were a race. And then I realized, I'm like, it's not really a race. You know, like I used to think it was like, if you do this first before other people, you're ahead of them. But it's not, right? I used to think that, like, when I'd see, like, my friends start to get engaged at, like, 26, 27, one had a kid. One of my friends has 2 kids already, and one of them's 5 and 7. Like, literally, like, my friend's kids are going to be parents before I'm a parent. But then I was like, you know what? It's not a race, because if I were to speed things up right now and just do all these things and then not be happy, I'm losing. The running joke in the family is that Wes, nephew, is going to be a dad before I'm a dad. It's the running joke. Dad, and then I'm adopted. Those are the 2 jokes. Not funny jokes, but yeah, they love that. That one's their favorite. Nephew's going to have kids before I do. I didn't get married until 45, right? No, hush. Hush. Thanks, Deanna. Everyone has their own time. Yeah. It's tough, though. It's a tough thing to take in. I always told my little sister she was adopted. My sister never told me I was adopted. My parents told me I was adopted. With a straight face. Like, Reid, you are adopted. You don't look like anyone in this family. I was like, wait, actually? They're like, of course, actually. And then after a while, I'm like, wait, really? And my dad's like, no. We have pictures of you when you were a kid. You look like your dad. I don't think I look like him sometimes. I definitely don't look like my mom. For sure don't look like my mom. I never said that. I know, I'm just joking, guys. I gotta stop making these jokes because we're gonna fall for this. No, Black AT mom and Black AT... You guys did say I was adopted at one point. But like as a joke. You did say that. But you didn't take the plate away from me at 34 seconds. That was a lie. You have your dad's eyes. It was a running joke in the fam, though. No, my parents were awesome. My parents are awesome. They raised me very well. I wouldn't change much, like, as a parent. I literally take a lot of things from both of them, and I'd like to apply that as a dad. Hi, Maria Vasquez. How are you? You'll be sitting on the stairs when you get home. No stairs. The stairs are done. No, that's finished. Once I hit, like... The stairs basically stopped once I hit, like, 26. She's like, it's enough. you were a kid, I used to be able to just kind of squeeze my way past you and get up the stairs, but now you're a big boy. You should know how to chew with your mouth closed, all right? And I have to get up and down, so you're on your own, bud. You're on your own, okay? Figure it out. Figure it out. It's not hard. It's not rocket science there.
Phone. Yeah, my phone's dying. 20%.
Oh, I don't want to go home. What are you up to tomorrow? I don't know. You have your dad's humor. I do have my dad's humor. We're not very funny, but we try to. It's the, like, attempted effort. Yeah, my dad tries, which is good, you know? Because how else are you going to ever be funny if you don't try? Right? Got to make efforts. Brandy, thank you. Or Brandy, welcome. My goodness. She's just like, thank you for what? I just got here. Huh? Oh, Tender Surrender's here. Long time no see, Michelle. Long time. Welcome. Jin Chow. Love your humor. Thanks, Lana. I forgot to take my funny pills this morning, so slacking a bit right now. You're funny when you don't think you are. It's always when we're not trying. I almost threw my spoonful of soup in it when you honked that. Uh-oh. Deanna. How's it going, Michelle? How's it going? How is it going? Let's see who's live. Nikki Nightmare. Myrna. No way, Jen Miller's live? Parker. Nikki Nightmare, Troy. You're from Indonesia. Welcome, welcome. Chattel. It's hard to chattel these days. No one really answers. Michelle, thank you. Thank you for the hearts. Let's go. Multiple hearts. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Oh my goodness. Single. Seis. Siete. Ocho. Tiffany with a corgi. My goodness. GGW all at once. Let's go, Tender Surrender. Let's go, Tiff. Hi, Lori. Thank you, thank you. When we go off, we all go off simultaneous. It's like, you know, like together all at once now. Let's go, ladies. A one and two and three and four. One and two and three and Tracy. One and two, three, four. All together now. Now we're topping. And Susie. And one and two and three. Tracy, Susie, thank you. The simultaneous GGW. Thank you, thank you, guys. Susie, let's go. Yeah, where has Tender Surrender been? Welcome. Let's go, Lisa. You have nothing to give. You give your presence, and that's enough. You're here. That makes me happy. Right? Don't forget that. Where's Hunter? Right. Miller might chattel you. No, I don't think so. I'm kind of scared of Miller right now. She's got like 45 people in there. You know? She has like the same amount as me. Like, holy. Chill out, Miller time. Chill out. Thanks, Deanna. Okay, I'm gonna turn back on the car, chill for a little bit longer, and then we will start making our moves. Oh my goodness! Surrender with the blooming ribbons. Let's go. The heck is that sound? Why is my car going? That doesn't sound good. I know my car's been making such weird noises. Hello? Is it hungry? I don't know. What are you supposed to feed a car anyways? Tire fluid? That did not sound good. I'm kind of nervous. Mary Lise, welcome. It turned on, you're right. It's good. We have to always think of the positives, guys. Like, we can actually...
Oh my goodness!
Yo, out of nowhere, Dottie throws the race car. That sounds better. Holy, Dottie, thank you so much. You broke Reid. My mouth was just like in perma lock. Dottie, let's freaking go. Thank you so much for the race car. Just coming to pick you up. It sounds better than my car. Let's just leave this here. We'll take Dottie's race car. Thank you. You looked frozen. Dottie, don't you have a birthday coming up? You do. Birthday vibes. You think I'm gonna forget? No. Thank you, Dottie. Thank you. Lana first. Okay, Lana's first. And then, well, both are celebrating big birthdays. That's right. No way. Wait, you guys were born the same year? And Chrissy's on the 19th. Okay, guys, please remind me because I hate missing birthdays. I feel so bad. I always try to wish everyone a happy birthday, but like, and yours on the 14th. Okay, damn. Okay, we gotta, oh, there's so many birthdays. And then Karen's on the 28th. Okay. Just remind me, please, if you're ever in a live and it's your birthday, let me know, because I like to wish you a happy birthday. I don't want to forget. Tender Surrender with the Galaxy. Oh my goodness, Michelle. Let's go. Let's freaking go. Yours on the 14th. No way. And we got, I believe, Papa's birthday is coming up. Papa Casey's birthday is coming up on the 14th as well, I think. If Blackie Teen Mom's here, she can confirm. Yep. Papa Casey's birthday is this month. Got a lot of birthdays this month. Thank you, Michelle. Thank you, Dottie. April 4th. That's a good birthday, Trace. Lonnie, yours is the 26th. Tiffany's March 25th. Is everyone's birthday in March? Holy. Christine, thank you. Yeah, I got a lot of birthdays. I love his name, Casey. Isn't that a cool name? Casey. You're top 26. I know, guys, we're top 26. Don't get me hyped. Don't get me going nuts. Why is number 16 on Daily Ranks invisible? Who is he? We should watch a movie together one night. That'd be fun. Next milestone. Birthday present too. I wish we could watch a movie together, but I can't show you guys the screen for copyright reasons. But that'd be cool. I wish we could do that. Your birthday is May 23rd. Nice. The day after Blackie Teen Dad's birthday. Does anyone want to guess how old Blackie Teen Dad's turning this year? Who wants to guess? How old is Blackie Teen Dad turning on May 22nd of this year? What's the birthday? What is it? It's a special one. That's right. It's a special one. No, not 63. 69. Yeah, Blackie Teen Dad's turning 69 years old on May 22nd. Yeah, 69. Yeah. Yeah, because Black Kid, Teen Mom's 5 years younger. She just turned 64. So 69. It makes me sad. What a party, I know. I don't know if he's going to be home for his birthday, but it's a big birthday. When's your birthday? June 22nd. Your mom's turning 77. Let's go. Are you and dad going to do a pizza live? We should. We did that. You remember that? Good memory. Mary Elise with the boxing gloves. That's your signature. That's your signature one, Mary Elise. Let's go. Merci beaucoup pour le... comment est-ce qu'on dit en français, le boxing glove? Je ne sais pas comment traduire ce mot. Le glove de boxing ou quoi? Comment est-ce qu'on dit ça? Le gant de boxing. Oui, merci. Merci beaucoup. My mom and I share a birthday. That's cool. I love that. My sister and her... What do you call your... What would my sister call her husband's brother? Is that brother-in-law? Yeah, brother-in-law. My sister's brother-in-law is the same birthday. Lonnie with a galaxy. Le gond de box. Thank you, Lonnie. Thank you so much. Lonnie's going off today. Brother-in-law. Yeah, so my sister's brother-in-law is the same birthday as her. So she married into a family where she doesn't have a birthday to be celebrated on her own. Her brother-in-law. This ain't Texas. What is this? I like this. This is the Beyonce song. No way. This is the Beyonce song. Everyone's been asking, have you heard the new Beyonce song? Oh, she's from Texas. No way. I like this song. This is good. The same Texas. Get that off of me. It's enough. We're done. Dottie and Gia, simmer down. I've had enough. I just had a great workout. Let's not kill this vibe, okay? And we're listening to good Texas music. My goodness. Tracy. Whoever's laughing right now in the chat, putting laughing emojis, you realize you're not helping the situation. Tracy. Gee, it's enough. Okay, and this, we got someone from Thailand right now laughing. Excuse me, I don't find this funny either. Okay? You think because I'm coming to visit your country, all of a sudden you can laugh at me? Maria, it's enough. Are we done? Oh my God. It's enough. You too busy trying to find that blue I saw. I let my black hair grow and my weasel. sweat too much on the regular. We gon' let them hits fly. Thanks, Susie. Thanks, Lisa. Thank you, Gia. Lana, ma'am. Courtis, Ontario. I swear down there. Courtis, Ontario, that's where they got the tractors. Right. Is that right, Lana? Right? Right? Oh, I love you too. Why do I always say Courtis? It's Curtis. Sarah with the crown. Let's go, Gaudette. And Maria with the forever rosa. Thank you. Top 25. Let's go. Dottie, thank you for the garland. So pretty. So pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. I'm just trying to swim in something wetter than the ocean. Faded out the double cup, I'm mixing up the potion. All I want to do is make the Lana's going off. She just threw it. You're amazing. Let's go, Lana. Oh, that's Curtis. Is it actually pronounced Curtis? I always say it wrong too. I think so. Thank you, Lana. Will you get on live when you get home? No. No, not tonight. Tonight we're doing a lot of car lives, eh? We'll do a live in the actual room this weekend. Thanks for coming on. Oh my goodness, Tracy still has the Christmas gifts. My goodness, who still has the reindeers and their gifts? Thank you, Trace. Thank you for coming on live tonight. I really needed some cheer up. Thanks for being here. Merry Christmas. Has anyone put up their Christmas lights yet? It's coming up. No? It's coming up, guys. Do it now before summer. Don't want to be the last person putting up your Christmas lights, do we? Right? So might as well start getting them up now. Right? We're almost there. It's almost 2025. Oh, it's still up. We just don't take them down ever. That way we never have to put them up. Yeah. Dottie with the reindeer. It's always mass. Mass is always lost. Even in hockey. Might as well get ahead of it, right? That's the spirit. Yeah, might as well, right? That way you have less responsibility in the future. Mm-hmm. Might as well. Serves us best, right? So, why not? Yo, how do you still have those? Dottie, you have to click update. If you go to the App Store and you click update, it'll update. You're 7 months behind. The audio with the gingerbread cookie foam party. Gingerbread foam party. Let's go, Dottie. Oh my goodness. Let's go. Does someone still have the dance together gift? Maria with the train. Who has the treehouse still? If you have the treehouse gift, you literally haven't updated your phone in like 2 years. Maria LG, thank you. Dottie, thank you. Jen, thank you for tapping. Jen Eagle's been tapping. Same with Deanna. I like the treehouse one. I also like the planet. They got rid of the planet. Guys, I don't know what that sound is, but it's really bothering me. This ain't Texas. I can't get that out of my head. This ain't Texas. La 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 la. You missed the planet. That was Connie's. Connie loved the planet. Samantha, thank you for the gingerbread man. Gingerbread man. Susie with the disco love. This ain't Texas.
CHFI, Toronto's perfect music mix. It's the John Tesh Radio Show. Real quickly here, we want to help you make better financial decisions with some intel.
Tracy with the ski goggles. How do we still have these? Do a TikTok to Texas Hold'em. Does anyone have a Tesla? I love Teslas. They're so nice. They're so sleek. Samantha, it's enough. Thank you, Samantha. I love Teslas. They're so cool. Yeah, too expensive. I love them though, they're so nice. And it has the CarPlay. Stop telling me what to do. Samantha. Hi, Vanya. Your boss has one. Pulls up at work. Dottie's like, damn. You said you weren't gonna listen to John Tesh again. Who's John Tesh? I don't know what that is. I never made that claim. I don't even know what that is. You have CarPlay? I love CarPlay. If automatically, if someone has CarPlay, I'm like, I love your car. Actually, if you have a real rear view camera on your car, like if you can see what happens when you're like reversing, you automatically like, I love your car. Special song request since you're in the car. I wish I could play a better song. Oh, that guy, the earlobe guy. Oh, don't kill me. Wait, how do you remember his name? Judy. How do you remember his name? John Tesh. Wow. Is that like... Wait, is John Tesh like a celebrity? Like, who is he? Oh, he's well known. Who is that? I'm smart. But wait, who is he though? He used to be on Entertainment Tonight. What is that? Oh, E.T. E.T. Canada. John Tesh. Wait, so why is John Tesh making claims about earlobes? I don't understand. Is he a doctor? Guess what kind of car you think we drive? Oh man, I don't know cars at all. Like, I literally, that's my one thing. I do not know cars. Yeah, I don't even know what kind of car I have, honestly. I think it's an ES3 something. I wish I could play that Mary Lise. I wish I could, but. This song will always remind me of Debbie. You know why? Because Debbie wrote me when I was in Thailand and she said, I would love for you to do a beach TikTok. And I was like, Debbie, well, we hate the beach. And she's like, make my day, make a beach talk. And I was like, all right. So we went to the beach the next day. We made flowers TikTok. That was for Debbie. That's for Debbie. Susie, thank you for the flowers. Yeah, she was so happy. She loved it. Smiles for Debbie. Thanks, Susie. ¿Cómo estás? ¿Está bien? Yeah, but I wish you could buy me flowers. What kind of flowers do you want, Mary Lise? I never know what to get. Do you want roses? Do you want orchids? Dottie, thank you for the garlands. Thank you for the roses. Mary, let's go. Thank you so much, guys. Has anyone ever bought themselves flowers? You should. You should buy yourself some flowers. Do something for yourself. You like buying flowers for friends? My mom hates flowers. hates it. Does anyone else hate flowers? She hates flowers. But I get it. It's just responsibility and stuff, right? And we had cats and stuff. So apparently there's some cats that like can't have flowers. Oh, Jen doesn't like flowers. You're allergic. You love fresh flowers. I want boxing gloves. You fight with my hands. I'm not against with. Oh, you want me to fight with you? I'm not a fighter. I'll watch you though. Cheer you on. I'll be your like towel girl. Flowers brighten up a room. They do, but like honestly, I'd rather just fake flowers. Ain't nobody have time to water them. The heck? Black 18 Dad would go to Florida and he'd be like, can you water my flowers? And I'm like, sure. And I expected like one like pot or two. And he had like 15 pots of flowers. And I literally like, I don't know how to water flowers. Like I didn't know how much water to put. And anyways, I showed him a picture and it was like the water was like swimming in the soil. And he was like, bro, you're literally killing my plants. I'm like, I don't know. I'm not a flower. Like, do I look like a florist? I don't know what the heck I'm doing. You asked me to flower your plants or water them. There's water in the plants. It's done. I did it. I fulfilled the responsibility. He's like, yeah, but now I don't have plants anymore. They're dead. I'm like, yeah, but I don't. But you asked me to water them. So I did that. There's water inside. So he's like, yeah, but not that much water. Well, I didn't know. I figured but more is better. If they're thirsty, they'll drink it eventually, no? I don't freaking know. Listen, I didn't go to flower school. I don't know what the heck this is all about. Just buy fake flowers next time. Or don't ask your son. I'm sure your daughter can do it. She's good at that stuff. She loves flowers. Oh, it's not a florist. It's called a horticulturist. Okay.
Baldwin came out. Mama, give me that funk, that sweet, that nasty, that crusty stuff.
You were a florist, no way. That's cool. Florist. Everyone's had his green thumb. No, I suck with that kind of stuff. Did you guys see that guy give me a dirty look? He's like, bro, did you just pull down your window in front of my girls? Excuse me? Were you trying to check them out?
Hey, bro.
What's up, dude?
Good, bro.
You want to say hi to my live?
Yeah, hi.
There's 87 people.
Oh, hi.
What's up?
Are you just filming us?
No, bro. I'm filming myself.
Oh, that's okay.
You want to be filmed?
No.
Oh, you can come in and bring them.
No.
Can you wish them happy International Women's Day?
Oh, that's okay.
Okay, have a good day, bro. Careful, guys. We got 88 people. We're gonna watch my back. You gotta kill them with kindness, guys. That was alpha male coming out. Bro, he literally got pissed, eh? He literally got pissed at me. Are you filming us? Excuse me? Why would I film them, bro? I thought he was gonna literally come, did I ask him to come on live? I don't remember that. Did I say that? But I just want to make sure it gets like out of here. Oh, I said to bring the girls too. Because I'm like, bro, he can't be that serious right now. There's no way. It's not that deep, bro. It's not that serious. Oh, you said I'm on with 87 people. I think that saved me, eh? Otherwise, he's coming for me, eh? If I Yeah, that was it. That was it. Once he heard there's 85 beautiful women here, yeah, he's like, I'm out. I'm out. I'll stick to my two. People don't like to be filmed. I don't blame him. I don't blame him, but I wasn't filming him. I don't think. Was I? Guys, was that going to be my first fight on live? Like, I got witnesses. He's definitely following me home tonight, right? We should all hang out. All of us. All 85 of us plus them. Wait, why wouldn't he want to wish them happy International Women's Day? That actually bothers me so much. He's with two women. He called us beautiful, I did. But why wouldn't he do that? Oh, now Mary Elise is like, are you kidding me? No, I know what happened, guys. I was like this.
Like that. That's exactly what happened. So yeah, he did think I was filming. Okay, I guess I wasn't the wrong. But I wasn't really filming. Mary Elise, thank you.
He's out of here. Samantha! Poor timing. Wait, well, guys, was that wrong of me? Did I handle that wrong? I always, whenever things go wrong, like with social interactions, I always, yeah, Gia's got her shovel. Was that, like, I always think I'm like, shit. Should I not have handled that way? Did you like how I hit him with humor?
I don't think he liked that. Cause I think he was looking for like me to be kind of scared or like intimidated. And then I kind of hit him with some humor and he's like, bro, you're supposed to be scared right now. Like, I'm trying to intimidate you in front of my girls and look tough, and you're supposed to be look like freaked out. So can you please respond appropriately? Because now they're looking at me like I'm not that tough. Okay, let's let this go. I hate stuff like that. I'm gonna rewatch that part of the live. I have to rewatch that part. Guys, what if I got beat up on cam? Maria with the flying jets. She's coming to rescue us. He's like, hang on. I got Gia's shovel and I'm coming. I'm coming. Watch out. Okay, Gia's shovel is no joke. Maria, thank you so much. We'd all be calling the popo. Lawsuit. This is not a dangerous area, but Maria, thank you so much. Gia, don't play. Who is up on their hind legs right now? Kind of scared me a bit, I'm not gonna lie, because I literally thought he was gonna come reach in my car and like take me out, be like, you want to handle this as a man? Maria's sending in the air forces. Samantha's nails are ready. What'd you say? Your car door is locked. Nah. Scared you? Wait, if I wasn't live, would that have gone different? We don't want to be on film. But, like, what would I have done with it? Like, you know what I mean? Like, what would I do with, like, video of him? Like, watch it later, you know? He doesn't know that's true. Okay, but no, honestly, guys, what the heck would I have done with that video? Like, in his head. What was his worry? Like, I'm gonna, like, make, like, a film out of it, you know, and, like, show my friends, put it on Facebook. Like, him and his friends drinking booster juice. Like, come on now. He was looking for a fight. Yeah, he definitely was, eh? He definitely was. He was. Good morning, good morning. Oh, maybe that wasn't his girlfriend. Maybe he was out with two girls. Oh, okay. We gotta get Rock Angel to put some Photoshop stuff together of him. Oh, maybe religion, culture, true. I don't know. It's not that deep, though. Thank you, Marks. Thank you, Michelle. People are cray-cray. I know. Imagine we're in, like, Chicago when this happened. I'd be freaking out. Or, like, Columbia. How long have we been live today, guys? 3-4 hours. Wow. 4 hours. No, the area I'm in is very safe. Very safe. Were you nervous? I mean, I'd rather not that kind of stuff happen on a live, yeah. I usually try, like, to create peaceful environments wherever I am. But, you know, with all the traveling we've done, can you believe that not one person said to us, "Are you filming me?" What if I said, "What if I am?" What if he was like, "Bro, are you filming me?" I'm like, "What if I am, bro?" Like, chaos. Chaos. So we did handle it well. We were nice about it. Just a request right now. Okay, I'm just gonna decline its side neck. I always try to be nice. Those are fighting words. I don't fight. I don't like to fight. Reid, can we get a tweet that you're home safe? Don't do that. Don't say that. Now I'm freaked out. Hello? We're good, right? Don't do that. Has he left? Yeah, he's left. He's not coming for me. Reed's a lover, not a fighter. I can buy myself flowers. No, I'm not gonna tweet when I get home. Why? Because we'll be okay. We'll be good. Why are you looking for more people? I want more. That wasn't enough. I want more. I want to create more of a scene. Where are they coming from? Booster Juice. Strong boy. Strong boy. Lord is hello. Timing. C-1035. Where's Lizette? Lizette? Are you here? We could have offered him the ripped shirt. Yeah. But I'm not filming you, but I did rip my shirt a couple weeks ago on a live, and I still have it. Do you want it? You don't? Okay, do your girls want it? I can see one of them.
Oh, wasn't, yeah, it wasn't that song. Never mind. It was Middle of the Night. You're right. What up, Karen? I missed that live. Can we get a redo? That'll never happen. It's kind of like eating a tomato. Never happen. There's certain things that will never happen on a live. Never sing on a live again with like music and stuff. No, that's done. Ripping the shirt's done. And ever eating a tomato, it's never been done, but will never happen. If you don't know what to do with that t-shirt, my birthday is coming up. Let's go. It's a big one. It's a big birthday. What the heck are you laughing at, Gio? What did I say? What did I say now? Oh, it's probably the tomato comment. Gio's convinced I'm going to eat a tomato. It's never happening. Never. The song was before Middle of the Night. You're right. That's why I got confused. You've sang every live since. No. No. I haven't. It's not true. What if I beg? Don't beg. Never say never. Never say never. Standing ovation. Yeah. Is someone's name Will's Panda? So dumb right now. Wasn't I trying to reenact a scene once with this song, and I like try to make a romantic, and I like laid down on the bed once with the song playing, and I thought it, the lyrics were like, you are so loved right now, and I'm like, you are so loved right now, but the lyrics were, yours look so dumb. Do you guys remember that? It was supposed to be like this romantic vibe, and then I ruined it. Can I see calves for my birthday? No, I mean, nothing compared to Joshua's, but, excuse me, are you filming me? Are you filming? Look at those calves. My goodness. What if I am? What if I am? What if I said yeah? No, I am filming, but it's for, I'm actually creating a documentary. Yeah, and is it, can I have you guys in it? Perfect. Okay, so what I'm trying to do is this like documentary where it's like, what do people do in parking lots? And you guys are actually my first guests on the show. Are we still talking about this, Chantel? I was like, literally, it's annoying. Stop. It happened 47 minutes ago. Stop. Let it go. No, I don't let things go. I take so long to like let things go. It's enough. We're still talking about like the hoodie we lost in Thailand. So guys, if I'm not live tomorrow, send an alert. Alert, alert. Standing ovation. Okay, we're gonna get going soon, guys. Who's the creator? Samantha, thank you. Susie, thank you. How's it going, Sylvia? What's up, what's up? I love the part where it goes, oh, whoa, whoa, like loud. Let's go. That's a great song, Sheriff. Hi, Steph. What's up? What's up? Long time. Beach Girl Anderson in the house. Thanks, Samantha. What's up? What's up? Thanks, Laura. Drive safe, please. Michelle, shotguns in my house too. We got everyone here right now, eh? Holy, let's go. We got definitely the 69 crews here. This song was my sister's first dance at the wedding. Nice. I actually think I was wearing this exact hoodie when I did this song. How weird is that? I think I was wearing this outside, right? That's weird. I don't even wear this much. Can you tweet when you get home? You guys are that worried, eh? If you want me to, I'll tweet when I get home. But we have to decide now, because if I say I'm gonna tweet when I get home and I forget, everyone's gonna be like, we'll get home okay, guys. The guy's not following me. There's nothing to worry about, right? We'll be fine. Jen, I'm nervous. Jen? Jen? Yeah, it's enough. She's like, I don't speak that language, okay? I'll tell you when I'm done, okay? I'm not done yet. So you better sit there and enjoy these cowboy vibes. Okay? I'll let you know when I'm done. Not yet. Hang in there. Oh, it's a disguise. Okay, we literally gotta have that on the whole time home. Mustache and sombrero. And they'll never know. Honestly, I'm more scared of the two girls. They seem kind of feisty. Him, not so much. He seems kind of soft. I'm joking. Reid, do y'all call white van with dark glass kidnapper? No, not here in Canada. Lonnie! Let's go with the galaxy! Thank you, Lonnie. Thank you so much. Thanks, guys. Thanks for your love. Karen, thanks for tabbing. Parking lot's clearing out. It's almost time to go home. But what a fun time it's been, eh?
We always have a good time together, right?
I love that. Take the best shower. Guys, yesterday my shower was so hot. It was the hottest shower ever. Like, literally, like, steaming. I wanted to see, like, how hot I can make it. And I was so cold that my body was freezing, shivering. So I turned up, like, full max. Bro, the steam was insane. Like, I got out of the shower and I couldn't see anything. It was the hot shower. You should record that. Hot shower vibes. What do you prefer, steering wheel on left or right? Wait. Well, I only know of the left. I've never driven with the steering wheel on the right. So left. Left. Probably felt hotter because you're cold. No, I'd actually do the opposite. Like, because I was so cold, the hot wasn't even hot enough. Like, I needed more hot. I took a 45-minute shower yesterday. Literally. It's a long shower.
It's going to be the kind of, like, brain scan amazing. I mean, obviously, we're talking about the fact that there's studies.
Top 22. Let's go, baby. Love a good burn, right?
Is there any hot water left? I sure hope so. I sure hope so. All right, we're gonna head home soon. Red light, yeah. Some guys, Celine Dion.
Have I done this TikTok yet? Because you love me? Can't remember.
Goody. Thank you for the shooting star. I did, right? I don't remember it. It would be muted. Japan. Japan. In that really cool museum. Yeah, did it. True, guys, I am who I am. I'm Blackie because you guys love me. Is that's really deep, but let's talk about that for a second. I am who I am because of you guys, because of your love. It's true. If you didn't love me, I wouldn't be Blackie. I'd probably want to be Blackie, but I wouldn't be able to be Blackie. The shooting star is back. Wait, yeah, right? Let's go, Michelle. Where'd you find that? Only in Texas. It's a Texas shooting star. Sarah, thank you. Yo, it's back. The shooting star is back. Since when? Let's go, Elisa. Guys, when did that come back? We missed that. It was gone for like a couple weeks, no? Not just Texas. Florida's coming in, baby. I love Florida. Thank you. Isa, thanks for tapping. I see you. Steph, love you too. Fell in love with you, so thank you for creating this and creating us. Much love. And you're from Alberta, fellow Canadian, Deanna? Connie, thank you so much. I just saw it today. I think this is the first day of the shooting star. The return of the shooting star. Let's go. I missed that one. Kristen, I see you tapping. Thank you. Leda, hello. Fort Vermilion, Alberta. Is that near Lake Louise? You Florida Keys I've never been to, but that'd be cool. If you live in Florida, then Jamaica, here I come. You got your passport? I've never been in the Keys. I don't even know what Florida Keys is. What is that? Where is that? Florida Keys? The only keys I know in Florida are the ones I use to get into the gym. Yeah, Riri's gym. What keys? Is that like Sarasota? Lisa, we'd finish with some J-Lo if we could, but unfortunately we don't have that capacity. Wait, wait. Imagine J-Lo was on. No J-Lo. Bye, double. You can stare at me as long as you don't have me. Islands at the bottom of Florida. No way, those are called the Keys? I didn't know that. Ooh, boy, you're looking like you like what you see. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have the meetup this year. Yeah, no, it's gonna happen. But it's probably not gonna be as organized as the first time around. It'll probably just be a restaurant. But yeah, we're gonna do it in 2024 for sure. And it's probably gonna be in Florida, but yeah, I haven't planned it yet, of course. But we will, promise. If you're still around, if you hang in there. Crap, we have 2%.
Whoa. This song was also in the slideshow that I made with my students. This is weird. Tonight's weird, guys. Thanks, Kristen. Thank you. I love that song. That was weird, guys. That was weird. Literally two songs in that slideshow, and they both played on the radio tonight. That's really weird. Are you questioning if you'll be here? Then stop saying we won't. No, I'm not questioning anything. Samantha, don't scare me. It's a sign. What's the sign? What is it then? The sign is that this is a new beginning. It's a new beginning. It's the start of something. It's the start of something new. It feels so right to be here with you. Oh. And now looking in your eyes. The start of something. No, I wasn't singing. That was Aaron. It was a mix of Aaron and Laura. They were both singing. But it sounds like me. But when those two sing together, it sounds like me. You got mixed up. You got fooled. Haha. That wasn't me. I'm never singing again. That wasn't... Oh, no. Not still waking up, guys. It's like literally 9 a.m. You're going to believe her? She's in Perth. She's like... Her eyes are still closed. And we're going to fall for that?
For all your temporal lobes for being able to find the timing of the key. It's so good.
Yeah,
so good.
Yeah, and don't be stopped by thinking you have to read sheet music.
Do they sound Canadian?
Music theory. Just sit down, pick out your favorite song off the radio or off of a CD. Or
your favorite John Tesh song.
There it is.
This week at CHFI.com.
You could win a family 4-pack of passes to the Toronto Zoo.
The Toronto Zoo? What are we going to see?
Get more at CHFI.com.
Feel the deal this weekend with Leon's March price.
Yeah, why did John Tesh get mentioned again? Guys, too many weird things are happening tonight. I heard that too. I was like, why is John Tesh on the radio? Take us to the Toronto Zoo. Would you guys want to do that? I'm scared of driving downtown though. Can we go to the zoo this summer? Daddy, bring me to the zoo. All right. You have to behave though. Uber to the zoo. Zuber. It's enough. Stop. You're not being funny. Stop. It's too late. We're not laughing. Zuber. What do you call an Uber ride on an animal? A Zuber. Is that funny? Kristen's laughing. That's good. We got one Texan to laugh. Why are the other Texans not laughing? Aaron's liking it. Okay, Gia, can you laugh too? She's like, but that's not funny. I know, but your other local friends are laughing. So, can you hop on as well? Okay. Just to kind of mesh in with them a little bit. Okay. Steph's laughing. That's fine. I found it funny. Kat's laughing. All right. Let's go. What do you call, this is the next joke, guys. What do you call a zebra ride? What do you call, No, I didn't take my funny pills today. I'm not a native Texan. Where were you born and raised? Holy, it's literally dead in this lot. I bet you that guy was gonna follow me home. And then he's like, this guy's literally not leaving. So we'll just mark down his license plate and we'll catch him tomorrow. Reid coming in with the dad jokes. Debbie, welcome back. The Zuber. Ugh.
Stack up the savings on Kudo Internet, a sweet phone plan.
I cannot dream. I'ma do just what I want. Looking ahead, no turning back. People told me slow my roll. I'm screaming out, off that. I'm screaming out, off that. I'm screaming out, off that. Off that, off that, off that, off that.
I saw your joke, Aaron, okay, and I was gonna steal it, and like, because only like 5 people saw it and laughed, so what I was gonna do is use it and take credit for it, but now 6 people laugh, like Laura now understands that it was your joke, so I don't want to, but I was going to take it and act like it was mine. I did that with Dottie's once. Dottie made a funny joke and I stole it, but do it? Can I still do it, guys? Okay. Can we all forget that Aaron made the joke? Okay, one second. Let me find it. Wait, let's let some time pass by so that we kind of forget about it for a bit, and then I'll bring it up soon. Okay, wait. Guys, I have a really good vegetable joke. I tell you, but it's corny. You have to put the laughing emojis now because I finished my joke. Yeah, put it now. Put it now. Put a bunch of laughing emojis. Yeah. Okay. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Let's hear it. I already said it. I made the joke. She's like, but it's not funny. I want more funny. That's not good enough. Okay, I don't have any more. That's it. Funny pills are in the console. What the heck is happening? What time is it? 10:30. One sec, guys. I missed it, but I'm laughing. Something fell, so I was trying to see if I could find it. What's going on there? Are you going to the gym every day with you now? Yeah, I gotta go every day. I've decided it has to happen. But not every day, but I can't take more than 2 days off in the week because then I don't get motivated anymore. So. Are you laughing at me? What is Alicia and Gia finding funny right now? I'm going to the gym 5 days a week starting now until Florida. So, is that funny? What's funnier, that or the corn joke? No, I'm actually going. Measure your biceps so we can, okay. Quick measure right now. Okay, so it goes twice around. So where the goal is by like the next 2 weeks, you want it to be like here. Though I actually got a good workout today. You guys are laughing at me, but I had a good workout. Okay, so everyone's just like, no, that doesn't count. No, I worked out really well today. Okay? Stop. No jacked. So you have a measuring tape? No, I'll just use my ruler. No measuring tape. Why would I have a measuring tape? Do I look like a contractor? I can't see. It's I was in the gym. I was in it. Did you go inside one? I was inside for an hour and a half. I still can't see. Stop. The freckle. Oh, my freckle. I got a lot of freckles. Freckle. I don't call them freckles though, they're called birthmarks. Where's the gun show? Beauty mark. Beauty mark. No, that's different. Birthmark. My sister has a lot. Actually, my mom has a lot. My dad doesn't have any really. I think we got that from Freckles or Angel Kisses. Wait, what's the difference between a beauty mark, a birthmark, a freckle, and a mole? Called Christie's Freckles Angel Kisses. Sharing the family secrets. Mm-hmm. Black 18, that's the only righty in the family. Someone who's been a part of the journey for like a year just found out recently that my parents were not together. Crazy, eh? Did you guys not know that? You guys knew that, right? They're like, no way. I'm like, bro, yes. You knew that? What, do you guys know what age my parents separated at? Do you guys know what age? How old was I when they divorced? You do not. I was 19. Actually, I was 18. It was my first year of university. First year university. Yeah, so they've been separated for 13 years. I was like, no way you didn't know that. You said 18. Yeah, 18. First year. Freshman year, as the Americans would say. Lonnie, thank you for the fire. Was it hard? It was really hard for me, yeah. Honestly, it took a long time for me to get over it. Dad remarried, that's right. Yeah, Dad remarried. I was the one that like kind of like showed him his wife. Kind of. Yeah. It was hard though. It took me a lot of time to get just, I think like as a kid, it's harder because you can't really make sense of it. But like when you're older, like once I was 18, 19, I could still make sense of it, but it was like a little, it was just still hard to digest. But you get to a point, whether you're 18, 19 or whatever, as an adult, you're like, yo, everyone deserves happiness. So you should want that. You should want your parents to be happy. Your daughter was 12. Yeah, I think they were waiting for my sister and I to be away at university before they made any changes. So I'm the youngest. So once I was gone, it was like, all right, I'm going to make some changes. But both people deserve happiness, right? So, but yeah, it was tough. Would it have been harder if you were younger? 100%. I think that's why they waited a bit. Because I think if I was younger, it would have been hard. They didn't want me to have to go back and forth between houses and stuff. But my parents were very amicable, you know, even to this day. There was no fighting. There was no fighting in my house, even though, you know. So they were very respectful to one another. And they still are to this day, you know. So that's nice to see. You know, I didn't grow up in a house with any arguing. It was like a very quiet house with, it was just a quiet house. The wife met through you. Yeah, so basically I was at the CNE one year, is the exhibition. We've been there. And I told my dad I wanted to try some food. So we went to this one hut and his wife was working in it. And they caught eyes. She's a lot younger than my dad, though. Parents are divorced, yes. Do you have half siblings? Honestly, like, yeah, they, like, I guess technically I have, like, what is it called? Like, step siblings? I guess I do. But I don't consider it step siblings because I'm an adult. So I just consider them my dad's wife's kids. One of them's my age and the other one's 4 years younger, but I don't really see them at all. I think like if you're like a, I think if you're a kid you can consider them your step or your half siblings, but like, yeah, I don't know, it's different. Exactly. Exactly. Do you know that 50% of marriages don't work out? More. I think I looked online as 53%. 53% of marriages do not work out. That is crazy. That is so crazy to me. Like, wow. Would you marry or date someone with children already? Would they like have kids with me? I can't judge the situations, because like, if I'm in love, I don't care. You know what I mean? Like, if you're in love, it doesn't matter. Whatever the situation is. So I would have to be in love to like decide, you know? But I would say I'm okay with that. No one tries anymore, they just give up. Yeah. Yeah. Honestly, it takes like, not work, but it takes like, you have to put effort. And obviously, like, when one person stops putting effort in a relationship, it doesn't work. Right? Like, it can't continue to work if only one person's putting effort. So both people have to care and want it to work. And if one person stops wanting it to work, then it's not gonna work. And then the other person's gonna feel like the other person's not putting effort anymore. And then usually this is what happens. I don't know, this is just my idea of it. Okay, you got a couple, okay? Both people are putting in effort. It works, they're in love. Okay, one person stops putting in effort. The other person notices. So this person stops putting in effort as well. Then this person is like, what the heck? This person doesn't care about me anymore. So this person starts putting effort again. And by that point, this person's checked out. So that's kind of usually, I think that's what happens a lot with effort. One person sees the other person not putting effort, and then it just kind of goes downhill from there. Because like, you know, eventually it's like, no, it's too late. You know, you can't put effort after the fact. So I've heard of that happening a lot. Communication's key, exactly. And loyalty, exactly. But I've heard about that a lot happening, where like one person stops putting effort and then the other person stops, and that, at that point it just like goes downhill. Takes a while to check out though. Man, I don't know. I don't really know much about it. Never been in one before, but I could imagine that it requires a lot. But honestly, if things weren't working between, you can't force something to, you know what I mean? Like, a lot of people will stay together for the kids, or like stay together for financial reasons, or stay together because they're just so used to it. They don't want to make huge change in their life, but you can't force stuff. So you can't force yourself to be happy in a situation where you're not happy, right? Because otherwise you're living a life that you're just not happy with, and that, you don't deserve that. So yeah, if you're not feeling something, you gotta go, you gotta get out of it. You only have one life, right? So find your happiness. Oh. It is hard. It is hard. It is hard. I'm acting like I know what I'm talking about, but I've never been in a marriage, so I can't really speak. I just, from what I've heard. Getting out is sometimes easier said than done. Yeah. But you have eyes. True, I do have eyes. I do have those. Mm-hmm. I'm in that situation, honestly. I don't want to like tell anyone what to do or anything, but I will say that you deserve happiness. And if you're not happy in your life, whatever it is, whether it's in a relationship, whether it's at your job, whether it's whatever, if you're not happy, don't stay stagnant. Because then you're going to get so used to being unhappy, and then that's going to be your life, being unhappy. What if, or just being like putting up with something that you're not happy with. And you shouldn't have to live that life, right? So, you know, when things aren't working your way, change, make change. But it's harder, it's easier said than done. So I got to stop talking. Took a long time to make change. But that's why communication is important too, right? Because, like, you can't make change without, like, communicating to someone, like, what's going on. Also, you know what I learned with life is never make decisions based on emotions. So, for example, let's just say you're really heated about something. Don't make a drastic change in your life while you're heated. Like, always wait for emotions. They always say, like, don't react with emotions. React with, like, rationality. Like, when something's bothering you, take time to, like, sit with it before reacting versus, like, acting on it based on your emotions. And then, like, because I'll notice, like, I'll be really upset, right, about something, and then I'll text something that I don't mean to text. So it's, like, always take time to, like, think about something, and then that way you can react rationally versus, like, with emotion. Because sometimes our emotional reactions are not us. So I get, like, really overwhelmed sometimes, and I'll do things that I regret, you know? So it's always important to, like, take time to just, like, think about things before you be proactive instead of reactive. I like that. Yeah, proactive. Proactive is like planning for the future, right? Like, to be proactive about something is to, like, get ready for something. But I'm working on that, because I definitely tend to react immediately. But I'm starting to notice now that, like, it doesn't help me. I have to stop doing that. Because me, I want to deal with things immediately. I want to solve things immediately. If something's not going my way, I want to talk to someone about it. Or, you know what I mean? But that's not always good, you know? You got to let time kind of pass by. And then do it. Have you guys seen this TikTok trend, the slow motion Walmart guy? If you say no, the guy was like, no. The slow motion guy, the guy who does the slow motion dancing. Really? We never know what I'm talking about. Ugh, ugh, ugh. No. No, period. Away. You've been off TikTok for a bit. You're my slow motion guy. And black and white too. Ready? We can literally create a gen edit right now. Okay, ready? Here we go. Guys, she's literally gonna make an edit to the slow motion. It's gonna be even slower than slow motion. This is no joke. Slow motion, slow. Slow motion, slow. Okay, that guy's gone, right? Like, we can go home? Yeah, we're good now. Watch, he's, like, on my driveway. He's, like, smiling at me. Hi. Hi. You waiting for me? Can you redo? What the heck do I look like? Don't say that. Don't say that. I missed it. It was too slow. We need a better song. I saw the coolest transition once. Some guy, like, did this movement where he went like this. And then, like, when he went like this, or he went like this, he went like this. Logan Copperwheat. Look it up. Look up Logan Copperwheat. He does this thing where he like transitions, but he like turns his like face himself, and then when he turns his face, like some light comes on. He does really good transitions. He's also jacked. Check out Logan Copperwheat. He just hit a mil followers. Let's see. Did you see Leo's TikTok for Valentine's Day? I haven't seen Leo's TikTok. Is it good? Leo's mom just had snakes all over him. No. It's crazy. Yeah, his he's got like an actual like cinematographer staff. So he's got like editors and videographers and like stunt trainers. Like this guy's got like, I feel like Leo's got like 50 staff working for him. It's crazy. Also, Christopher Cote is stepping up his videos now. Like they're like really clear, like HD videos. You can tell they were edited. Stepping it up, I'm like, damn. I'm just used to my like iPhone filming. Oh, thank you. I think you have a man crush. Cote? Cote's a stud. Cote's a stud. Anyone who says he's not, yeah. Cote's a stud. Sarah, thank you for the you're amazing. You're amazing. Thank you, Sarah. Thanks, Garen. That's it. Okay, we're gonna head home at 11, guys. 12 more minutes. I was in the washroom. Can you slow-mo again? We gotta find a good tune. Most of the stuff. Hope you can handle the heat. Put your yeah. Name in the street. Get used to my fans looking at you. What they heard, I'm with them birds of a mean kitty. Don't get put the rats in. Boys be mad that I don't. Incels, girls hate too. Took a pigtail, I love you. I want a big chill, boy, don't trip. I'll split a big bill. Take you around the world. They don't have to understand. Rub it in their face. Put a rock on her hand. Sunny, do you miss me? We haven't. Last time I saw you was in Australia. I wanna show you up. I wanna brag about it. I wanna tie it now. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. Yeah, yeah. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. Love is pain, but I need it. Yeah. Too good when the bean kicks in. Like Fortnite, I'ma need your skin. Yeah. Don't go with the boom. Boy, you're the one, you're the only man. Me and you are my only fans. Holy cow, you're the holy trend. Hold me down, wanna hold me. Be my security, it's your therapy. But you, I ain't holding back. When I need my space, you give that. When you broke my heart, you fixed that. With a long walk on the beach. Never when they Hong Kong from the street. When they see us zoom right in the cheek. We are whole damn, we are energy. Baby, we can just ride on our enemies. They don't wanna know how you get to me. Let them feel how they feel, let me feel the scenes. Cause this type of love's the epitome. So, yeah. Kissing, I hope they cut us. Whether they like or not. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. I wanna brag about it. I wanna tie it now. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. Yeah, yeah. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. I wanna show you up. Agoura Hills. It's too dark.
Association. It's about that time. temperamental, man or woman, the pump me up. Feeling fussy, walking in my Balenciennes, trying to bring out the fabulous. Cause I give a fuck, wait so much. I'ma need like two shots in my cup. Wanna get up, wanna get down. That's how I feel right now.
Guys, this reminds me of like 2022. When the song came out. Slow-mo repeat. I wish I could do the actual slow-mo moves. You know those people that like literally walk in slow-mo? Crazy. I'm gonna be alright, okay. Alright, it's about damn time. Guys, we have been live now for 7.5 hours. Not actually. We've been live for 5 hours. Wow. In a minute, I'm gonna need a sentimental man or woman. Crazy. Wild.
With the happy stack.
I want a good song to finish this off, like a really good song.
To find out more about our incredible.
The new album American
Dream. Oh wait, this might be available
everywhere. Get tickets now at livenation.com.
Amazing 5 hours. Actually, you enjoyed it? Love that.
I want the world to know. I got to let it show. I'm coming.
Say it loud and say it proud. Happy International Women's Day. Virgin Radio.
I'm a lead. I could keep my cool, but tonight I'm
live. Did I write short live on my tweet? If I did, I'm gonna be so mad at myself. I should know by now. I missed most of it. Work on the way again. Laura, what time did you finish? Thanks, Connie. Love a new year, too. I want one really good. Oh, I just saw her live. Okay, good. Does anyone work on the weekends? Does anyone have work tomorrow? Do they have country? Yeah, I just don't know what station. I have to sneeze. Sunday work? I just wrote live, okay, good. You work on the weekend, Connie? Maria's off this weekend, nice. Carol works. You work Saturday and Sunday? Work Saturday. Connie, you're off Friday, Sunday. Church on Sunday. Sneeze on cue about 4 hours later. Achoo! Bless you. Thank you, Dottie. Hi, Kamala. Shh. It's alright, it's alright. Just dance. It'll be okay. You work Monday to Friday and on call on the weekend. So wait, like, they can literally call you at any point and you have to work? What if you're, like, eating dinner with your son? I couldn't work another day this week. Work beat me up this week. Everyone's been saying that, eh? Like, everyone's been saying work beat me up this week. Was work just a brutal week for everyone this week? I've heard that from, like, 5 people already. Like, work's been tough this week. Is everyone just like, the employers are just like, tough? No, like literally everyone's been saying work has been tough this week. Why though? Is it because like the weather, like everyone's moody? Tough week for sure, eh?
Dropped her new album.
Major changes. You almost walked out, damn. Samantha's like, if you
I'm one thing at a time when it comes to work. That's the way to go. I'm just joking, Samantha. What's that thing? It's like, don't make me snap my fingers in a Z formation. You know? Don't make me snap. I will snap. Oh, that's no fun, Laura. That's no fun. That's her own boss, and she walks out on herself sometimes. She's like, I've had enough. No way, the guy came back, bro. Guys, we're like, make your own Blackie club right now. Oh yeah, Elizabeth, wind it up. Oh yeah. Oh my goodness. Oh baby. Yeah, Blackie club. It's Friday night in Blackie's car. And we are winding up. Laura's going nuts. Oh my goodness. Holy. Oh my goodness. Oh, whoa, whoa. Whoa. Oh. Imagine Blackie fan at a club. Step off the tables. Well, I thought we were winding it down, not up. Whatever way you want. Go nuts. We got the disco balls. I got my car light. Is it raining? It's raining. Place would never be the same. Guys, the cleaning fee would be insane, eh? We'd be going nuts. Maria with a disco ball. No one is around you. Say, baby, I love you. You ain't running game. Say my name, say my name. You acting kind of shady. Ain't calling me baby. But the sudden change. Say my name, say my name. You know one is around. Maria, thank you. Say, baby, Jennifer. You ain't running game. Say my name, say my name. You acting kind of shady. Ain't calling me baby. Better say my name. I would call, you would say, baby, how's your day? But today, it ain't the same. Every other word is a huh, you're okay. Could it be that you are at the crib with another lady? If you took it there, first of all, let me say, I am not the one to sit around and be played. So prove yourself to me, I'm a girl that you crave. Why don't you say the things that you said to me yesterday? I know you say that I am assuming things. I'm going down as a way of saying. Nobody's holding you back from me. I know how you used to do. When you're saying everything to me, times two. I need you to tell the truth. If somebody doesn't tell me who. Say my name, say my name. Say my name is around you. Baby, I love you. Ain't running day. Say my name, say my name. You ain't kind of shady. Ain't calling me baby. But you say my name, say my name. Baby. All right, it's 11, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed that 5-hour live. 5-hour live. Do you guys enjoy it? I hope you did. Thanks for joining me at the live today, or at the live today, at the gym today. Good times. We're going to go home and shower. And there's no post tonight, guys. I'm sorry. I'm just going to like go home and shower and get into bed. Try to not go to bed too late so we don't wake up at 3 p.m. All right. Well, that was fun today. That was fun. Thank you so much for all the love. No 45-minute shower. Thanks for all the love, guys. Tappers, if you were out tapping today, I like we went nuts. 170,000 taps. So thank you so much to everyone who taps. Guys, don't forget, tapping helps so much, and it's a huge way to show support. So view page, it's the reason that other people can it's the reason that other people can see me. So thank you to those who take time to tap. It really means a lot to me. And if you're just sitting here watching, your presence means a lot to me too, you know? So thanks for being a part of it, being in the live. And gifters, thank you so freaking much, honestly. Thank you so much. It means a lot to me as well. All the love. And people sharing the live, all of it. The comments help too. It shows engagement in the chat. That pushes me up on the FYP. So thank you to everyone who shows their love and however you show it. Thank you. All right, have a great Friday night sleep. Sleep well, sweet dreams. Have a great weekend, enjoy it. And I will not be tweeting when I get home because we're gonna be okay, all right? Be okay. Well, how about this? I'll like some stuff in the Facebook group. I promise we'll be good, all right? Love you all, and thank you for your love tonight as usual. Have a great weekend, and we'll see each other all very soon.